हेलो फ्रेंड्स, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट येट अ वेरी बेसिक टॉपिक ऑफ अलजेब्रा व्हिच इज अलजेब्रिक फंक्शंस व्हिच इज अलजेब्रिक फॉर्मूले. ऑल्दो इट लुक्स लाइक अ वेरी बेसिक टॉपिक, येट इट हैज इट्स ओन इम्पोर्टेंस व्हाइल सॉल्विंग द क्वेश्चंस. नॉर्मली स्टूडेंट्स आर वेरी कंफ्यूज व्हाइल सॉल्विंग द क्वेश्चंस एंड दे डू नॉट नो हाउ टू अप्लाई अ फॉर्मूला एंड इवन दे डू नॉट नो which formula is applicable on a certain type of question. So here we are going to discuss certain basic algebraic formula and their applications in the questions. So before the start of the topic, let us first get an overview of the things that we are going to discuss here. We will discuss some basic algebraic formulae here and then some questions based on these formulae, and then I will give you certain practice questions and their answer keys. Before the start of the topic, before the start of the questions based on the formulae, let us have a very quick overview of the formulae, which are very common, very easy, but still students are very much confused while using these formulae. So the very basic formula, the first formula is a plus b whole square equals to a square plus b square plus 2ab. Second is a minus b whole square, which is equal to a square plus b square minus 2ab. Now if I add these two formulae, I will get another formula, which is a plus b whole square plus a minus b whole square equals to, now if I add the above two formulae, these two ab and 2ab will cancel out, the result comes out to be a square plus b square, that means twice of a square plus b square. It is again a very important formula while solving the questions. Again, if I subtract the first two formulae, I will get a plus b whole square minus a minus b whole square equals to, now in this case a square and a square will cancel out, as well as b square and b square will cancel out, and it will become equal to 4 times ab. Next is a square minus b square is equal to a minus b into a plus b. The sixth important formula is a plus b whole cube. Now a plus b whole cube is equal to a cube plus b cube plus 3 times ab into a plus b. Similarly, if I write down the formula for a minus b whole cube, it will be equal to a cube minus b cube minus 3ab into a minus b. Next is a cube plus b cube. Now a cube plus b cube is equal to a plus b into a square plus b square minus ab. And a cube minus b cube is equal to a minus b into a square plus b square plus ab. And next, tenth formula is a plus b plus c whole square. Now it will be equal to a square plus b square plus c square plus twice of ab plus bc plus ac. So we have these 10 basic formula in algebra, which have a lot of applications in the questions. Now we will discuss how to use these formulas in while solving the questions. Actually, there are certain questions which can be solved very easily if we apply these formula. So from next slide onwards, we are going to apply these formulas to solve the questions. Now here the first question is, x plus 1 by x equals to 7, then what is the value of x square plus 1 by x square? Now look at the question carefully. The given part is x plus 1 by x. And the question is asking about x square plus 1 by x square. So how to get x square plus 1 by x square from x plus 1 by x? Obviously, we have to square x plus 1 by x. Even only then we will get x square plus 1 by x square. So here we have x plus 1 by x equals to 7. And we have to square to get the value of x square plus 1 by x square. Now square on both sides. So squaring on both sides, what we will get is x plus 1 by x whole square equals to 7 square. Now we know that a plus b whole square is nothing but a square plus b square plus 2ab. So apply this formula here, it will become x square plus 1 by x square plus twice of x into 1 by x equals to 49. Now this x and 1 by x will cancel out as they are reciprocal to each other. What is left behind is x square plus 1 by x square plus 2 equals to 49. And from here we get x square plus 1 by x square equals to 49 minus 2 by transposing this 2 on the right hand side, and it becomes x square plus 1 by x square equals to 47. This is the value which has been asked in the question. The question was asking about x square plus 1 by x square. So we can say that by applying the result a plus b whole square equal to a square plus b square plus 2ab, we are able to get the value of x square plus 1 by x square, which is equal to 47. Now, come to the second question. Now, if you compare this question by the previous one, in the question 1, we had x plus 1 by x, whereas in this question, we have x minus 1 by x equals to 14. Again, the question is asking about x square plus 1 by x square. Again, since we want the value of x square plus 1 by x square, there is nothing to do only to square the given part, which is x minus 1 by x. So here again, I am having x minus 1 by x equals to 14. Now, again, to get x square plus 1 by x square, I am squaring both sides of this identity. So on squaring both sides, and applying that, a minus b whole square is equal to a square plus b square minus 2ab, what I will get is x square plus 1 by x square minus 2 into x into 1 by x is equal to 196, as the square of 14 is 196. Now again, this x and 1 by x will cancel out, and what is left behind is x square plus 1 by x square minus 2 equals to 196. Now transpose this 2 on the right side, the answer becomes x square plus 1 by x square equals to 198. So if the value of x minus 1 by x is 14, then the value of x square plus 1 by x square will be equal to 198. I hope you have understood the application of a plus b whole square as well as a minus b whole square. Now come to the next question. This question says, if x minus 1 by x is under root 45, then what is the value of x plus 1 by x? Now in this question, we have to find the value of x plus 1 by x. Whereas in the previous two questions, the question was asking about x square plus 1 by x square. So here, in the question part, there is no square. It is simply x plus 1 by x. Now, we have x minus 1 by x equals to under root 45, what is asked is x plus 1 by x. Now we have a result that a plus b whole square minus a minus b whole square is equal to 4 times ab. If I take x equal to a and b equals to 1 by x and put these values in this identity, in this formula, the result will be x plus 1 by x whole square minus x minus 1 by x whole square is equals to 4 times a is x and b is 1 by x. Now I have to find the value of x plus 1 by x whole square, whereas the value of x minus 1 by x is given to be equal to under root 5, so it will become under root 5 square equals to 4, as this x and 1 by x will cancel out. So it becomes x plus 1 by x whole square minus 45 equals to 4. Or transpose this 45 on the right hand side, it will become x plus 1 by x whole square equals to 49, or x plus 1 by x is equal to plus 7 or minus 7 here, as under root 49 is equal to plus minus 7. So here we have two values for x plus 1 by x. One is 7 and the second is minus 7. So here we have used a plus b whole square minus a minus b whole square equals to 4 times ab. Now in this question, it is given that x plus 1 by x equals to 2, then find the value of x raised to power 8 plus 1 by x raised to power 6. So here we have x plus 1 by x equals to 2. You can remind this result that whenever we have x plus 1 by x equals to 2, it is true only for x equals to 1. There is no value of x other than 1 that will satisfy this identity x plus 1 by x equals to 2. Although you can prove it that x plus 1 by x equal to 2 implies that x is equal to 1. For that, you can simply write it as x square plus 1 is equal to 2x. What I have done is I have multiplied the equation by x, and it becomes x square minus 2x plus 1 equal to 0, or it is equal to x minus 1 whole square equal to 0, as x square minus 2x plus 1 is nothing but x minus 1 whole square. From here, the value of x comes out to be 1. That means if x plus 1 by x is equal to 2, then the only possible value for x will be equal to x equals to 1. So that means from here I can safely say that x will be equal to 1. Now question is asking about the value of x raised to power 8 plus 1 by x raised to power 6. Now since x is equal to 1, put x equals to 1 here, we get 1 raised to power 8 plus 1 by 1 raised to power 6, which is nothing but 1 plus 1 equals to 2. That means if x plus 1 by x is equal to 2, even then the value of x power 8 plus 1 by x raised to power 6 will be equal to 2 only. Now come to the next question. The question says that if a plus b is equal to 50 and ab is equal to 600, then find the value of a cube plus b cube. Now here we have two numbers a and b, their sum a plus b, their product as 600. The question is asking about a cube plus b cube. No doubt we can solve this question by applying the formula for a cube plus b cube, which is equal to a cube plus b cube is equal to a plus b into a square minus ab plus b square. But if we use that formula, we have to make a square inside the bracket. For example, I'm writing here a cube plus b cube equals to a plus b into a square plus b square minus ab. Now, I can use a plus b here. I can use ab here. Now, what to do about this a square plus b square? Now, here the question requires that I must complete the perfect square inside the bracket. So, I will just avoid this thing. Now, what I will do is, I will use the simple result which is a plus b whole cube equals to a cube plus b cube plus 3ab into a plus b. Now in this formula I can put the values of a plus b as well as a into b, and this a cube plus b cube will be my answer. So once again writing down this formula, a plus b whole cube is equal to a cube plus b cube plus 3ab into a plus b. So substituting the values, a plus b is 50, so it will become 50 cube, and keep a cube plus b cube as such, plus 3 into ab which is 600 into a plus b which is 50. So what is the cube of 50? It is 125000 equals to a cube plus b cube, and this will be equal to 90,000. Now transpose this 90,000 on the left side. So a cube plus b cube will be equal to 125,000 minus 90,000. So the result will be 35,000. So a cube plus b cube, which has been asked in this question, is equal to 35,000. So it is an easier approach rather than directly applying a cube plus b cube, where we have to complete the square inside the bracket. Okay, come to the next question. Here question says that if p is equal to 3 raised to power 1 by 3 minus 3 raised to power minus 1 by 3, then what is the value of p cube plus 3p? Now question is asking about the value of p cube plus 3p, and it is given that p is equal to 3 raised to power 1 by 3 minus 3 raised to power minus 1 by 3. Now if I have to find p cube, the only thing possible is that I cube the given result p equals to 3 raised to power 1 by 3 minus 3 raised to power minus 1 by 3 on the both sides. So cubing on both sides, we get p cube equals to 3 raised to power 1 by 3 minus 3 raised to power minus 1 by 3 whole cube. Now here we have 3 raised to power 1 by 3 and 3 raised to power minus 1 by 3 whole cube. If I take 3 raised to power 1 by 3 as a and 3 raised to power minus 1 by 3 as b, we have a minus b whole cube. And a minus b whole cube is nothing but a cube minus b cube minus 3ab into a minus b. So applying this result here, I will get p cube equals to a cube, which is 3 raised to power 1 by 3 cube, minus b cube, which is 3 raised to power minus 1 by 3 cube, minus 3 into a into b into a minus b. Now this 3 raised to power 1 by 3 and 3 raised to power minus 1 by 3, they will cancel out each other because they are reciprocals of each other. So what is left is p cube equals to 3, as this 3 and 3 will cancel out. Similarly, this 3 and 3 will cancel out. So it is equal to 3 raised to the power minus 1 minus 3 into, you can check that this 3 raised to the power 1 by 3 minus 3 raised to the power minus 1 by 3 is nothing but it is again equal to p. So I can write down here this 3 raised to the power 1 by 3 minus 3 raised to the power minus 1 by 3 as p. If you do not write this as p, there is no problem. This part will cancel out when you will put the value of p in 3p here. It will cancel out. Otherwise, I am writing down this value equals to p right here. So transpose this 3p over left side, so it will become p cube plus 3p equals to 3 minus this 3 raised to the power 1 by 3 raised to the power minus 1 is nothing but 1 by 3. So p cube plus 3p will be equal to 8 by 3. So this was asked in the question. The question was asking about p cube plus 3p, and from here we have the value of p cube plus 3p equals to 8 by 3. Okay, now come to the next question. Now here you can treat this question as it has two linear equations in two variables x and y, and you can try to solve this question by using the concept of linear equations. But the right hand sides have under root 53 and under root 11. So if you are going by the solutions of linear equations in two variables, the question will become a little bit complicated. What we will do is we will check first what has been asked. The question is saying, question is not saying about the values of x and y. We will treat this question as the question of linear equations in two variables if the question is asking about the values of x and y. Whereas, but the question is not asking that. The question is asking about the value of x square plus y square. So here, what we will do is we have a result x plus y whole square plus x minus y whole square equals to twice x square plus y square. I have written this formula in the first slide where I discussed the formulae. Now, simply put the values of x plus y and x minus y from the question in this formula. So it will become x plus y whole square is nothing but under root 53 whole square plus x minus y whole square is nothing but under root 11 whole square equals to 2 times x square plus y square. From here we can say that twice x square plus y square is equal to 53, as under root 53 square is nothing but 53. Similarly, under root 11 square is 11, so it is equal to 53 plus 11. That means twice of x square plus y square is equal to 64. From here we can find x square plus y square is equal to 32, and this was asked in the question. So there is no need to solve the two equations simultaneously by treating them as the linear equations in two variables, but you can directly apply this formula to find the value of x square plus y square. What you have to do, first look at the question, what the question is asking, and after that just think which formula you should apply to get the desired result. Now here we have a statement based question. The question is saying that one day Raman asked Aman how many marbles Aman has. Aman said that if I divide them into two unequal parts, then 59 times the difference between the two parts is equal to the difference between their squares. Now you have to answer the number of marbles Aman has. Now it is again the question which is very simple, although it looks like a difficult question, but actually this question is very simple. Simply concentrate on what Aman is saying. Aman is saying that if I divide the total number of marbles into two unequal parts, let us consider these two unequal parts as x and y, and since they are unequal, so I will say that the two parts are x and y, where x and y are unequal. So these are two parts. The question is saying how many marbles Aman has. That means the total marbles with Aman will be equal to x plus y. So this is a value which has been asked in this question. Now, what else is given here? Question is saying that if I divide them into two unequal parts, then 59 times the difference between the two parts. Now, 59 times the difference between the two parts is equal to the difference between their squares. Now, this difference is equal to the difference between their squares. So here on the right hand side, I have x square minus y square, and we know that x square minus y square is equal to x minus y into x plus y. That means here I can write it as 59 into x minus y equals to x minus y into x plus y. Also, x is not equal to y. As x is not equal to y, from here I can say that x minus y will not be equal to 0. And we know that we can always divide by a non-zero number on both sides of the inequality. And since here x minus y is not equal to 0, I can divide both sides of this equality by x minus y. So what I will get in the final result is 59 equals to this x minus y will cancel out. It is equal to x plus y. That means the total marbles with Aman are 59. This was asked in the question. Although it was a statement based question, looks a little bit difficult, but the question was actually very easy. Now come to the next question. Question says that the sum of squares of two positive numbers is 19. And their product is 15. So let us take the two positive numbers as a and b, where both a and b are greater than 0. Question says that their sum of squares is 19. So what is given here is, first part is that a square plus b square is 19. Also, it is given that their product is 15. What has been asked? Question is saying that find the sum of the cubes. That means question is asking about a cube plus b cube. Now we know that a cube plus b cube is equal to a plus b into a square plus b square minus ab. So if I just concentrate on the values which are given here, I can say that I have the value of a square plus b square here. I am having the value of a into b. What is absent from here? That is a plus b. So first of all, I have to find the value of a plus b. And for that, since I am having a square plus b square as well as ab, I can say that a plus b whole square is equal to a square plus b square plus 2ab. Now just put the values. 19 plus ab is 15, so 2ab will be equal to 30, which is equal to 49. So from here, a plus b whole square is equal to 49. That means a plus b will be equal to 7 or minus 7. Now I will reject this minus 7. Why? Because it is given that a plus b both are positive. So if a and b are positive, their sum cannot be a negative number. So from here, I will reject this minus 7 so that the value of a plus b becomes equals to 7. Now I have everything which I need to solve a cube plus b cube. I have a plus b, I have a square plus b square, as well as a into b. Now just put the values in a cube plus b cube identity and it will become a cube plus b cube equals to a plus b is 7 into a square plus b square is 19 minus ab is 15. So it is equal to 7 into 4. So from here we can say that a cube plus b cube is equal to 28. So this was the question. this was a value which was asked in the question. So a cube plus b cube, sum of the cubes of the two numbers, as numbers were a and b, so their sum of cubes is equal to 28. I hope you all have understood this question. Now come to the next question. This question says that sum of the roots of a cubic equation is 21. If the sum of product of the roots taken two at a time is 110, find the sum of squares of the roots. Now in this question, the equation has not been given. Just question says that sum of the roots of a cubic equation, but there is no equation mentioned in the question. So let us take the roots of this cubic equation as a, b and c. Let the roots are a, b and c. What is given? That sum of the roots is 21. That means the first thing which is given here is sum of the roots. That means a plus b plus c is equal to 21. Next, it is given that sum of the product of the roots taken two at a time. Sum of the product of the roots taken two at a time means ab plus ac plus bc. Sum of the product of roots taken two at a time. Now this is equal to 110. And what has been asked in the question? Question is asking about the sum of squares of the roots. So a square plus b square plus c square has been asked in this question. Now as the question is asking about a square plus b square plus c square, and there are three parameters a, b and c, what we will use here is, so we will use a plus b plus c whole square, which is equal to a square plus b square plus c square plus 2 times ab plus bc plus ca. That means a plus b plus c whole square equals to a square plus b square plus c square plus 2 times ab plus bc plus ac. Now just put the values in this formula. We have a plus b plus c equals to 21, so it will become 21 square plus. This has been asked in the question, so just take it as a square plus b square plus c square plus twice. This value has been given here, which is 110, and square of 21 is 441 equals to a square plus b square plus c square plus 220. Just transpose this 220 on the left side. What we will get is a square plus b square plus c square equals to 441 minus 220. That means a square plus b square plus c square is equal to 221. So this was the result which was asked in the question. So these were some questions which were based on the simple algebraic formulae which are very common in use. I hope you all have understood these concepts and how to apply the formulae while solving the questions. Most of the algebra is based on these formulae, and we should know, we should have the right approach, we should have right approach with us how to apply this formula to solve the question. Now here are some practice questions for you people, and you have to solve these questions as we have discussed in this session. Just go through these questions. Just try to apply the things that we have studied today. These are the next three questions. And these are the answers to the previous six questions. I hope you all have got the concept how to apply the algebraic formulae while solving the questions. Okay, thank you very much.